From the air, Lake Burton is a serene emerald blue body of water surrounded by a breathtaking layered mountain view. And from up here, it's hard to know what secrets lie beneath. Before it was a lake, Burton was a town in Georgia's pioneer frontier of Rabun County. And before it was a town, this area was the home of the Cherokee Indians. The Cherokee tribe had ceded the land through a treaty in 1817, and Rabun County was founded in 1819. Following the War of 1812, land lotteries were held in many areas of Georgia, including Rabun's Tallulah River Valley. Lottery winners, with new plots of North Georgia land and settlers, began taming the wilderness for lumber and farming. The town of Burton was founded in 1874 by Jeremiah Burton. By all accounts, Jeremiah Burton was a prosperous man. His family owned the two mercantile stores that served Burton and North Georgia. The town had a flourishing school and church where many of the town's social activities were held. Because of its remoteness, the citizens of Burton tended to marry people from the area. The Tallulah Gorge had become a tourist and honeymoon destination. Burton would survive the Civil War and would help lead Georgia's recovery from the devastation of the war. This is a brief look at what would become Lake Burton from its earliest days to its final days as a town, when it was flooded to make way for a new source of power.
When they first started building the grid, powered by steam-powered generating plants, hydroelectric power didn't exist. But once it was developed, there was a land rush on dam building. A Union general named Harding came down here and was taken to Tallulah Gorge, which was a bit of a tourist destination. It's the deepest gorge in the east, 1,000 feet. It was the second leading honeymoon destination in the United States after Niagara Falls. There were 15 or 16 hotels there. Well, he came up there and looked down in it and said, we can generate a lot of power here. And he started buying land, and that failed. Other people came in.
At the time, the Tallulah Gorge was the number two destination for honeymoon couples and featured large hotels. Further upriver, the town of Burton was beginning to flourish and expand.
There was one village, one town in Rabun County, Burton, Georgia. It was the second largest town in the county of Rabun. That town had church, it had schools, it had everything to be a self-sufficient village. It was a town of its own. It actually stood right in the heart of the valley where Lake Burton had to go. So part of the process for building that meant that entire town, including the cemetery, had to be relocated. Everybody sold their property, and when that lake was filled, all those homes were left standing.
So it was a big town. They also had crops. They were farmers as well. They had the syrup mill. They made sorghum and cane, just regular syrup. And, of course, corn for the good old moonshine, corn liquor. They had a church, and the church was active. And I believe the church was part of the singing convention that they would have. They had a music school, pretty elaborate for the time. They would have all-day-long singing schools from, like, 9 o'clock till 3 o'clock.
But with the growth of Atlanta, Burton was about to undergo a dramatic change, one that had not been contemplated by Jeremiah Burton, but his descendants found too hard to resist. It started when a man came to town dressed in all black and riding a buckboard. He went from house to house with a simple offer. He wanted to buy their property, and he would pay top dollar.
As they did with all the other lakes, they had purchasing agents, people that would go around and purchase land from the owner if it could be found. So they hired a man named J.E. Hardy. He was from Tallulah Falls. He was a big man in girth. And there are accounts of him going around to the 65 families at Burton buying their land. And he wore a black coat, blue shirt, black pants, and a big black hat, rode in a buckboard with two horses. And he actually paid top dollar. So he bought out 65 families, and The Morse Brothers Lumber Company were contracted to come in and demolish the town.
Georgia Railway and Power Company had purchased land to create a series of six dams to provide the newly developing hydroelectric power system. Yet the new power generating plants needed a large amount of gravity-fed water. But there was one problem. The town of Burton stood in the way. The series of dams and hydroelectric plants were dubbed the Tallulah Project. But this new idea was not without its opponents. While the Tallulah Project was ambitious, it also aroused opposition. One of the leading opponents was Helen Dorch Longstreet, the second wife of Confederate General James Longstreet. Longstreet owned two weekly newspapers that she used to promote her strong political beliefs, along with lifelong efforts to honor her husband's Civil War service.
Another cause that she espoused was opposing Georgia Power's efforts to put a dam at Tallulah Falls. She was not against hydroelectric power, but she believed that a dam in this instance would really ruin this beautiful natural site. And so she formed the Tallulah Falls Conservation Association, and she went all over the state of Georgia campaigning against Georgia Power, calling them pirates and buccaneers and all kinds of terrible names. She failed in her effort, and the dam was put in.
Lake Burton had become a popular summer getaway for many Atlantans. It was a place to escape the summer heat. Margaret Mitchell and her husband would be among those who chose the lake as a summer destination. As the Tallulah Project was winding down, prohibition had become the law of the land. The Depression had overtaken America in the 1930s. And the Persimmon Valley in Rabun County would become a center for production of moonshine. The Tallulah Project had helped create new industry and new roads throughout the state. These new ribbons of blacktop would allow for a new kind of unsanctioned commerce. Still in the grips of poverty, many people in Rabun County resorted to making moonshine to put food on the table. The moonshiners employed runners, who used specially outfitted cars called hot rods. They built their reputations and fortunes by outsmarting and outrunning law enforcement. The drivers called it riding lightning down Thunder Road. They held races to determine who had the fastest car. Georgia's Highway 9 to Atlanta was dubbed Thunder Road. Lake Burton and the other collection of Tallulah Watershed power lakes would provide a vital source of energy for decades to come. After the onset of World War II, nearly two-thirds of the water would be drained from Lake Burton to provide power to the Bell Bomber plant in Marietta, Georgia, that would later become the aerospace giant, Lockheed Martin.
I think the lake represents one of the best examples of our acceptance of our responsibility when it comes to stewardship of the land and the environment. Still a wonderfully clean and pristine place to enjoy the beauty of nature. And when you understand and travel that whole North Georgia lake system all the way through the gorge itself is just a magnificent geological creation. And the fact that we were part of creating that and preserving it and contributing to its preservation is a huge benefit, and it makes me really proud of the company.
The lakes of the Tallulah Watershed and Lake Burton continue to provide a scenic recreational resource for boating, water sports, and fishing, while its shores, coves, and inlets provide a natural habitat for diverse wildlife, such as black bears, deer, amphibians, birds of prey, and waterfowl. Today, Lake Burton continues to be a vital part of the hydroelectric power project and a beautiful natural resource where thousands enjoy numerous outdoor activities in this idyllic setting. Like many communities around the country, Burton and its residents have experienced countless beautiful moments on its waters and shoreline. But there have also been some challenging days. On April 27th, 2011, Severe spring thunderstorms spawned devastating tornadoes that ravaged Lake Burton and parts of the Tallulah Valley and its surrounding communities. Dozens of homes on Lake Burton were destroyed, and many more were severely damaged. One family would lose a loved one. Today, with homes fully rebuilt and with forested land nearly recovered from the powerful force of the winds, a memorial park was built on land donated by Georgia Power to commemorate the events and to remind people of the original town of Burton. Now, fully into its second century, Lake Burton continues to be as pristine as it was when it was created in 1920. Today, it remains one of Georgia's most treasured monuments to the Southeast's natural beauty.
Who knew it was about to be? Sunrise, sunburn, sunset, repeat. Moonlight all night crashing into me. Nothing will ever be easy as you and me. Tangled up and nowhere to be. Just sunrise, sunburn, sunset, repeat. Sunburn, sunset, repeat.